It's easy to take the terrain in which we live for granted. While we are accustomed to seasonal changes, the geographic features surrounding us appear eternal. To witness a glacier calving huge chunks of ancient ice into the sea, or liquid rock steaming down a volcano slope, is to realize that the appearance of permanence in the planet's features is just an illusion. If we could accelerate our passage through time, the Earth's surface would reveal itself to be in continual and dramatic flux. Until the 1960s, scientists thought the continents were fixed in their present positions. But our awareness of the dynamic nature of our planet has grown as scientists have determined the origins of geologic features. Perhaps the most difficult topographic features to explain have been the majestic mountain ranges that texture the Earth's surface.
Mountain belts are very complicated. Well, actually, I worked in the Appalachians for years, and it was getting so complicated, I thought I might do something else.
If one looked at field geology, the incredible complexity of a place like the Adirondacks, that there's no hope of having a grand theory that would just integrate all this in any kind of a neat way at all.
Even when observing the awesome might of a volcano or the perpetual power of the sea as it pounds rock to sand, it is difficult to comprehend a force that can thrust untold tons of rock skyward, creating a mountain range. It wasn't until we were able to explore the bottom of the sea that the giant puzzle of terrestrial topography began to fall into place.
The geologists had built the science on walking around on land and never walking around on the bottom of seafloors, and couldn't understand that maybe what they were looking at on land was really explained by what's happening under the oceans.
The ocean floor has a huge system of high ridges and deep trenches along which earthquakes and volcanoes are concentrated. The seafloor is relatively young close to the ridges and relatively old close to the trenches. This information pointed to a new interpretation of mountain ranges. Scientists suggested that the Earth's crust, or lithosphere, is broken into a number of separate pieces, or plates, and that these plates move. The name given to the gargantuan forces associated with this movement is tectonics. In the 1960s, scientists brought these observations together to create a revolutionary theory called plate tectonics, uniting many different observations that we make about the Earth. Plates grow at the mid-ocean ridges by a process called seafloor spreading, and are destroyed in the trenches by a process called subduction. The continents ride along on these plates.
And so if the motions are together, you have a subduction zone because one plate has to go down beneath the other one. If the motions are away, if the plates are moving apart, then you have spreading ridges, seafloor spreading. And then you can have the other possible motion is one plate is moving sideways with respect to the other, and you have a shearing motion like the San Andreas.
The force of continents colliding creates earthquakes and volcanoes and builds mountain ranges.
So today what we know is that continents move, they move around at approximately the rate your fingernails grow, not your toenails, they're much slower, and that in an interval of approximately 200 million years, the Atlantic Ocean is formed. Geologists could spend their entire careers looking at mountain belts and never figured them out because the answer is not in the mountain belts themselves, but in the plate margins of the present Earth.
The rocks here in the northeastern United States provide good opportunities for studying plate tectonics. How, for example, can we understand the origin of the Catskill Mountains?
Now, the Catskills are part of the Appalachian Mountain System, which is a major mountain chain formed a couple hundred million years ago. It is, in fact, a relic of the collision between several major continental land masses.
The history of the Catskills began around 700 million years ago, when nearly all the continents were together in one giant supercontinent. About 600 million years ago, this supercontinent began to break apart, with ocean floor forming between the fragments by seafloor spreading. About 500 million years ago, the spreading stopped, and the continents began to move back towards each other. Roughly 380 million years ago, the continents collided, pushing up the Appalachian Mountain Belt, of which the Catskills are a part.
The important thing that plate tectonics did for us was to say, what's not there is important, the information that has been lost by ocean closing and subduction.
The theory of plate tectonics is one of the great achievements of modern science. The record of hundreds of millions of years of seafloor spreading, subduction, mountain building, and erosion can be found right here in the rocks.
Plate tectonics is the theory that unites and explains almost everything in geology. It is the basis for our modern understanding of the Earth.